Time now for Cooking with the Captain.
So today we'd be making a nutty swine, or pork chops in a peanut sauce. We'll be needing some boneless pork chops, thinly sliced, one medium yellow onion, two medium zucchinis, garlic, mustard powder, powdered ginger, some quinoa, some peanut butter, some extra virgin olive oil, sesame seeds for garnish, and water so that the quinoa isn't kind of crunchy. So let's get started, shall we?
First thing you want to do is slice up your pork chops about half-inch strips by around 2 inches. And I usually leave the pork chops semi-frozen for this. It makes slicing them a lot easier. After you have them nice and sliced up, put them in a bowl and set them aside. Now, using a clean cutting board, you want to start in on your zucchini. You want half-inch to 1/4-inch medallions. And then your onion. I'm going to use about pretty much the whole onion here. Slice it up and then mince it really fine. Now add 1 cup of quinoa and 3 cups of water into a pot and about 2 teaspoons of garlic and 1 teaspoon of powdered mustard. Turn that on until it begins to boil and then drop it down to a simmer and cover it up. Now add some oil into a frying pan on medium heat. Dump in your zucchini medallions. Stir everything up so that they're nice and separated and well coated with the oil. And saute them until they begin to brown. Just a little bit brown like that. Now add your onions. And saute this until the onions start turning translucent. After that, add your pork. Stir this up really well. Then turn the heat down to medium. And cover it up. Let it cook for 5 to 7 minutes. Now uncover. And stir everything up really good. You want to add 1/4 cup of peanut butter. And it doesn't really matter what type of peanut butter you use. We're using Trader Joe's chunky peanut butter with unblanched peanuts. Now add 1 teaspoon of garlic and 1 teaspoon of ginger. Stir everything up really well. Cover it back up and let it simmer for another 5 to 7 minutes. Now uncover it and stir it up until it thickens up nicely. And then add it over the quinoa, sprinkle it with sesame seeds, and there you are. Bon appetit!